things. I hope you all are safe at home. Today, let's start with our new topic of English prose. But before starting, let's recap. In the last chapter, we had done the topic robotics and we had learned about its features. I hope you all have understood that topic very well. Now, today, let's learn something new. The story of a king of Banaras who was very fond of hunting. Is it very interesting and curious to know about the whole story of a king? Yes. So, let's start with today's new topic, the noble stag, the story of a king. Students, now I will narrate you the whole story. Please listen it carefully, everyone. Let's start now. There was once a king of Banaras. His name was Brahmadatta, who was extremely fond of hunting. And luckily, on the outer part of the city means outskirts of the city, there was a huge forest filled with the deers. Among all of them, there was a mighty stag. Stag means a male deer. The meaning of stag means a male deer. Mighty means powerful male deer. One day, the king had gone for hunting with his courtiers. Now, courtiers means persons at the king's court. He ordered his courtiers not to allow any deer to be escaped. Otherwise, they will be severely punished. Severely means harshly punished. So the courtiers formed a tight circle so that no deer to be escaped. They began to beat their sticks on the ground to frighten the deers. Hiding in the bushes to make them run. There was a clearing in the circle where the king found his place. He stood there with his bow and arrows ready. The courtiers were beating their sticks on the ground and were shouting. Suddenly, a stag came out of the thickets. Thickets means thick plants of the brush. Thick growth of the shrubs and the plants. Thickets means thick growth of the plants and the shrubs. The stag saw that the king was standing in the way. So the stag looked the king straight in the eye and made a dash towards him. The king was taken aback and he shot an arrow towards the stag. But unluckily, he missed the mark. But the stag rolled over. The stag has an excellent instincts. Instincts means thinkings. He was very intelligent. And he was also very good at dodging. Dodging means those who know the tricks, those who know to move aside quickly to avoid an arrow. He was very good in dodging. The arrows from any side it is shot, and if an arrow is aimed at its belly, he will pretend it to roll over and then jump up and run once the danger has been passed. So when this stag rolled over, the king thought that the arrow had found its mark. The king load his bow and he moved towards the stag. Then suddenly the stag jumped away and ran away, jumped up and ran away. The courtiers started laughing on the king for missing his aim. The king thinks himself as an excellent marksman. What is the meaning of the marksman, students? Those who are very expert in shooting and hitting a target. And he could not bear any more the taunts of these courtiers. Taunts means insult of the courtiers. So he grabbed his sword. Grab means he removed quickly his sword and went to the forest to catch the deers. For chasing the stag, he covered a very long distance. The stag hid himself in the ground that was covered by a rotting tree, and it was also filled with slime. Slime means an unpleasant thick liquid substance. I repeat again, slime means an unpleasant thick liquid substance. And at a distance smells like a dirty water. But the king could not sense the pit and he fell right into it. He could not understand the pit there. After a while, the stag had realized that he was not being followed any longer. So he understood that the king had perhaps been fallen into the pit. So the stag went back into the pit and saw that the king is struggling for his life. Seeing this, he felt very sorry for the king and decided to save the life of a king, as though king was following to kill him. The stag told the king not to worry and be brave for a while. He caught a huge rock with his hind legs and lowered himself into the pit. The king caught the hold of his neck and the stag climbed onto the level ground and brought the king to his safety. The king thanked the noble stag and asked him to return with him to the Banaras and demand whatever he will demand, he will get it. But the stag refused him and told him to rule wisely and be kind to the animals. Seeing this, the noble stag disappeared again in the forest. And the king vowed that, vowed means he took a promise that not to hunt or harm any animal anymore. So, I hope all have understood this story which I had narrated you all just now. Now students, it's the reading time. Please open your textbook, page number 69. I will read out the chapter once and take pencils in your hands for marking the hard words. Wherever I feel like explaining the meaning of the word, I will explain it. Okay students, so let's start the reading part now. Lesson number 32, the noble stag. As we all know, King Brahmadatta of Benares was extremely fond of hunting. Underline the word Brahmadatta, underline Benares. Luckily for him, on the outskirts, underline the word outskirts. Outskirts means, as I told you earlier, outer parts of the city. Outskirts of the city was a huge forest filled with deer. Among them, there was a mighty stag. Mighty means powerful. Stag means a male deer. One fine day, the king had gone hunting with his courtiers. Underline the word courtiers. Courtiers means persons at the court of a king. He told his courtiers, "If you allow even a single deer to escape, I will punish you severely." Underline the word severely. Severely means harshly. So the courtiers formed a tight circle from which no deer could escape. Then they began to beat their sticks on the ground to frighten the deer hiding in the bushes and to make them run. The only way out of the circle was through a small clearing where the king stood ready with his bows and arrows. The courtiers were beating their sticks on the ground and shouting when suddenly a stag came out of a thicket. Underline the word leapt, underline the word thicket. Thicket means thick growth of shrubs or plants. The stag saw that the king was standing in the way. So he looked the king straight in the eye and made a dash towards him. The king was taken aback and shot an arrow towards the stag hurriedly. Underline the word hurriedly. Of course, it missed the mark, but the stag rolled over. Now, there is one thing that you must know about the stag. It has excellent instincts and is extremely good at dodging arrows, whether shot at from the back. Underline the word dodging. Underline the word instinct. Instinct means excellent thinking. Dodging means those who moving aside quickly to avoid an arrow. Those who are very experts in moving aside quickly to avoid an arrows. Whether shot at from the back, front or even the top. If an arrow is aimed at its belly, underline the word belly. Belly means stomach. It pretends, underline the word pretends, to roll over and then jump up and runs once the danger has passed. So when this stag rolled over, the king thought that his arrow had found its mark. He lowered his bow, underline the word lowered, and began to walk towards the stag, underline the word stag. But the stag suddenly jumped up and shot past the men. When the courtiers realized that the king had been mistaken, underline the word mistaken, they started to laugh. Now the king thought himself to be an excellent marksman. Underline the word excellent. Underline the word marksman. Marksman means a person who is very skilled in shooting, in hitting a target, and could not bear the taunts of his men. Taunts means insults. Underline the word taunts. He grabbed his sword, underline the word grabbed, and set off into the forest in order to catch the stag. He chased the stag, underline the word chased, for quite a while and covered a long distance. The stag came upon a hole in the ground that was covered by a rotting tree and filled with the slime. Underline the word slime. Underline the word rotting. Slime means an unpleasant, thick, liquid substance. I repeat again, slime means an unpleasant, thick, liquid substance. From a distance, it could smell the dirty water and so was careful not to run over it. But the king could not sense the pit and fell right into it. After a while, the stag realized that he was not being followed any longer. He understood that the king had perhaps fallen into the pit. So the stag went back to the pit and saw the king struggling, underline the word struggling, for his life. The stag felt very sorry for the king. He decided to save the king's life even though the king was following him with the intention to kill him. The stag told the king not to worry and to be brave for a while longer. He then caught a huge rock with his hind legs and lowered himself into the pit. The king caught hold of his neck and the stag climbed out onto the level ground and carried the king to the safety. Finally, the king thanked the noble stag again and again and asked him to return with him to the Banaras, where he could have anything and everything he wanted. But the stag did not want anything in return for his help. He just requested the king to rule wisely and well and be kind to the animals. Then the noble stag disappeared into the forest. Underline the word disappeared. King Brahmadatta, underline Brahmadatta, then vowed, underline vowed, not to hunt or hurt any animal. I hope all have understood this story very well and all have enjoyed also. Thank you, students. Stay home, stay safe.